Good afternoon, everyone. My research is focused on the development of drug delivery systems, including micro nanoparticles, providing modified, controlled, and stimuli-responsive drug release. Development of diagnostics agent, combining the functions of drugs and tools for imaging, early diagnosis, and treatment of cancer disease, is an important task in the field of designing drug delivery systems. Systems based on polyelectrolyte microcapsules are promising candidates for combining both functions. One of effective methods for obtaining polymicrocapsules is layer-by-layer assembly of alternatively charged polyelectrolytes onto substrate surface, which allows encapsulated the functional components in a polyelectrolyte shell. Polyelectrolyte microcapsules have been shown to be promising delivery systems for many high and low molecular weight compounds, such as proteins, DNA, lipids, and pharmaceutical substances. Using the layer-by-layer method for fabrication microcapsules make it possible to include the components not only inside the carriers, but also onto the surface and in between the layers of the polymer shell. In this study, we used calcium carbonate microparticles as substrate for prepared polymicrocapsules. The major advantage of microcapsules is promising containers for the delivery of pharmaceutical substances in the possibility of a modified release of functional components responding to various physical or chemical stimuli, as well as the protection of encapsulated components from destruction by the environment of microcapsules and reduce its side effects to normal cells. Here we have demonstrated a technique of the obtaining of core shell and core shell polyelectrolyte microcapsules containing doxorubicin as model pharmaceutical substances and characterized the system prepared. We reported the key stages of the preparation of microcapsules containing calcium carbonate microparticles as matrix core and the dox loading by two methods. Primary incorporation of doxorubicin into the core, followed by the application of polyelectrolytes and loading of doxorubicin into preliminary obtained hollow microcapsules. In the first case, the dox are embedded in the substrate and after that, polyelectrolyte layers could be applied. In the second case, the dox are encapsulated by changing the permeability of microcapsules membrane by varying the parameters of the environment around the microcapsules. The microcapsules with a hollow soft structure can be prepared by a removal of the template core from microcapsules. And since microparticles of calcium carbonate are composed of matrix and pore structure characterized by a highly developed surface suitable for absorbing polyelectrolytes and drugs, enjoy the possibility of modified drug release of the last, which make them also promising drug delivery vehicles. The resulting calcium carbonate microparticles and doxorubicin loaded microparticles had an average size ranged from 1 to 3 micrometers. The microparticles are characterized by a narrow size distribution, an almost regular spherical shape, and also negative zeta potential that ensure their use as templates for absorption of polyelectrolytes on their surface. The polyelectrolytes were applied on the substrate in the following order. The measured surface charge values of the microparticle samples during each step of deposition of polyelectrolyte layers confirmed that the surface charge of the original matrix as well as the surface recharge of each polymer deposition are sufficient for the effective absorption of each subsequent layer. Initially, shell structure docks containing microcapsules were prepared by spontaneous loading. Docks are encapsulated by changing the permeability of the microcapsules membrane by varying the parameter of the environment around the microcapsules. Spontaneous loading is mainly based on electrostatic absorption, in particular positively charged doxorubicin and negatively charged polymers. The data potential of prepared doxloaded macrocapsules also presented on the slide. The change in the surface charge of macrocapsules upon spontaneous loading of doxorubicin is likely caused by the surface adsorption of doxorubicin, which leads to decrease in the capsule's surface charge to the slightly negative values. Alternatively, dox encapsulation was performed by co-precipitation during the synthesis of calcium carbonate macroparticles. The homemade calcium carbonate macroparticles were obtained by crystallization sodium carbonate and calcium chloride solutions with glycerol added to the reaction mixture as a thickening agent. The doxorubicin solution was also added to the reaction mixture. The core shell microcapsules were prepared by layer-by-layer deposition of polymers onto dox containing microparticles. Core shell structure polymicrocapsules were obtained with different numbers of polyctrate layers. Thus, we prepared batches of doxorubicin containing microcapsules and microparticles for further drug release studies. To determine the amount of dox encapsulated, the dox content was determined by the indirect approach spectrophotometrically. The amount of dox in obtained microparticles were determined directly in the final product after dissolving the carbonate core. They correlate the dox content within the batches of dox-containing macroparticles and microcapsules prepared by different approaches. The dox quantity was verified in each set of the drug release experiment, ensuring an equal theoretical loading coefficient. The encapsulation efficiency and experimental loading content of prepared polymicrocapsules, polyctrolyte macrocapsules and microparticles presented on the slide. The cumulative release a quantity of dox at specific time were calculated by the formulas presenting on the slide. The analysis of dox release from the presenting systems was provided under conditions close to physiological pH and extremal pH at temperature of 37 degrees. According to the results, the burst release of dox occurred within 60 minutes for both microparticles and microcapsules after they were placed in the release medium. Moreover, the burst release was observed in the case of microparticles at both pH values. The effect of the burst release can be explained by dox molecules present on the surface of both macrocapsules and microparticles. Probably, dox molecules located at the capsule surface and within the external layers of the polyctrolyte shell are initially released into the medium. After the initial release rate decrease, diffusion of doxorubicin molecules located in the macrocapsule's interior to the external media is likely to occur. In the case of the macroparticles, dox molecules were extended to be encapsulated throughout the structure of calcium carbonate macroparticle and also localized at the particle's surface. The burst release of dox in the case of the macroparticles is supposed to be caused by the dissolution of the dox on the particle surface and erosion of the calcium carbonate matrix. In the case of macrocapsules with shell and core shell structure, the presence of polyctrolyte shells on macroparticle surface to decrease the burst release of doxorubicin in compression with microparticles. After 72 hours, the total cumulative release of dox for all presented systems didn't exceed 75% for both pH. This data allow us to assume the possibility of the prolonged release of doxorubicin from the microparticles core shell and shell macrocapsules. I would like to finish with some conclusions. The procedure of preparation polyelectrolyte macrocapsules with average size ranged from 2 to 3 micrometers, suitable for administration by injection and possibility of their functionalization with anti-cancer drug have been developed. The prolonged release of doxorubicin from polyelectrolyte macrocapsules at physiological and acidic pH was determined. The presence of polyelectrolyte shell on the microparticle surface decreased the burst release of doxorubicin. Moreover, the thicker the shell of the microcapsules was prepared, that greater the effect of prolonged release of doxorubicin. The obtained results pave the way to the development of theranostic agent based on polyelectrolyte macrocapsules with controlled release of the anti-cancer drugs and further functionalization of the system with diagnostic or imaging agents. Thank you for your attention.